On Sunday, we have the Eagles at the Browns. Now, this one, I know we can all say as of the news today, it gets a lot of question marks with the Cleveland Browns. The over under 35 and a half, I'm putting some question marks for. I don't know about you. I know that both of these teams, like we said, pretty high scoring in the first preseason games, but I like the way the Eagles are trending this season, why they're also favored. I don't know. Can Cleveland put points on the board, all things that have been considered this week, Scott?
Well, that's what's tough about this matchup. But, you know, when I look at games like this, again, it's when we look at the Eagles, they looked so great early in their first preseason game. They were up 14 to nothing. Then they got outscored 24 to 7 the rest of the way. So you're right. Can the Browns, you know, score enough here? But when you look at some historical information, too, this is crazy. This is what's crazy about this matchup, in my opinion, when you look at some of the history here, because the preseason is a different animal from the regular season. If there was, if this was a regular season game, I'm looking at the Eagles and I'm looking at them hard with them laying just 3 points on the road. But again, it's not. It's a preseason game. And the Eagles have only won once in their last 8 preseason games, only one straight up win. And then you look at the Browns, they've only lost once in their last 8 preseason games. And that one loss was by a single point. So if you're going to go ahead and take the Eagles and lay 3 points here, you're basically trying to fade an 8-0 trend on the Browns because they haven't lost a preseason game by more than a single point in their last 8 games. So again, I like to look at history more in the preseason because it tends to tell us a little bit more about how that coaching staff approaches the preseason. So like when you're talking about the Eagles, of course, we're only talking about last season that they had the new head coach, but still, again, the Eagles just, they didn't get it done last preseason either. And I think they'll put, this could be another case where they put out a good, strong first half performance and then they fade in the second half. And so I would have to take Cleveland plus the points in this matchup. Again, I know it's maybe one of those that, Hannah, we call these the ugly dog theory, you know, and this could be one of those ugly dogs, especially, you know, based on the current information that's come out with Cleveland, but still I would lean toward Cleveland plus the points in this matchup.
Yeah, and I think even though with all the question marks with the Cleveland Browns offense, their defense is still pretty solid. They have some veterans on that roster across the board that you would put a lot of faith in. So yes, the quarterback might be a little shaky, but there's a lot of talent on that roster that can do some things. So I like that, Scott. I'm here for it. Thanks for all your bets. I know everybody's excited, and don't forget, you can get all the guys' bets on picksandparlays.net using the promo code NFL. Saves you 20% off the entire site. Thank you so much, Scott, for joining me. Any final thoughts before you go? The NFL preseason underway again.
Well, just wanted to make one more comment because you were talking about this with Cleveland, and it's so true. Their defense got a ton of pressure last week and got a bunch of sacks and also got a couple of interceptions. So that Cleveland defense is a force to be reckoned with. Like you said, it's a pretty talented roster, especially on that side of the ball. And so something to keep an eye on for sure in that matchup. And then overall, by the way, Hannah, you were asking as far as like general thoughts about the preseason. I do think some of this scoring is going to level off. It's not just going to, you can't just, that's what's funny. Generally speaking, we're seeing value now because the totals got pushed up after what happened in week 1. Now you're going to see that there can be some extra value on some of these unders. You can't just go blindly play unders, but just keep an eye out for that. If you already liked an under, now you're getting some extra value too because the totals got pushed up after week 1. So just keep that kind of stuff in mind because the same thing happens in the regular season too that we see. If you see a bunch of high scoring games in week 1, the totals go up in week 2 and yet then that's when you start to see some unders. So it's always something to keep an eye on for sure.
Yeah, I'm really excited. We're going to keep all of that top of mind. Thank you so much for your expertise, Scott, and thank you for all of your picks. Again, this is Picks and Parlays, our Power Hour, brought to you by BetMGM. Thank you, Scott, for joining us. You're the best.
Thanks so much, Hannah. Thank you.